ותשר דבורה וברק בן אבינועם ביום ההוא לאמור. Oh, hi guys. I didn't know you were there. It just caught me reading chapter 5 of the book of Judges. As you know, we've been reading through the book of Judges and talking about the language and the text of the book. And chapter 5 is an amazing chapter. It's possibly one of the earliest parts of the Bible to actually having been written down. And the language of the chapter is what we call archaic biblical Hebrew. You know, no language stays the same over time. The language of Chaucer is not the language of Shakespeare, and the language of Shakespeare is not the language of Thatcher, okay, for that matter, or Trump, okay, or anyone else in our modern period. Okay, languages evolve, and they evolve due to many factors, okay? The language, the Hebrew language in the Song of Deborah is what we consider to be archaic biblical Hebrew. In our discussion of the Song of Deborah, we are going to talk about many of these features of archaic biblical Hebrew, okay? We'll talk about them, we'll demonstrate them, and we'll show how they are reflected in the text. I should also say that it's not going to be the only thing we're going to do when talking about this chapter. We'll also talk about the structure, the poetic structure, and even use the map. Luckily, you don't have to have your map with you. We'll do everything on screen, so don't worry about that. We'll have the map presented on screen as always, and you're more than welcome to join us. You can send me an email and we'll take care of the details. Bye-bye, guys.